Good morning, everybody. We're going to do a little bit of mathematics today on revival from the Bible. Let's just put down something on paper here. What is the value of this number? That's right, zero. Let's try this again. How about now? It's still zero? Okay. How about now? Still, okay. I'll try this then. How about now? It's still zero? Good grief. How about now? Oh, now it's 100,000. How about now? 900,000? Wow. What's the meaning of this illustration? Good question. Find out today on Revival from the Bible. So today we're reading 1 Corinthians 13, and that's a very familiar passage. Maybe it was read at your wedding, love is patient, love is kind, or the last verse now. But now, faith, hope, and love abide. These three, but the greatest is love. Well, the chapter starts with some more shocking language. It says, if I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains but have not love, I am nothing. If I give away all I have, and if I deliver up my body to be burned but have not love, I gain nothing. So how does that connect with our mathematics here? Well, maybe you've heard me use this illustration before, but read once an author I thought put it pretty well, that you know, the zeros represent a lot of the other things that we have in church. You know, here's our kids ministry. Here's our, you know, our facility. Here's, you know, hey, is the teaching any good? How good's our programming? You know, all the different things like that. But if you add them all together, and then this number here, this is like, well, what is our love like as a church? Because basically, if I have good teaching and great programs and a great facility, but we don't have love, what are we? We're nothing. Now, it's not to say these aren't important, because, you know, I would much rather have 900,000 than I would 9. No, they're important, but they're nothing if we don't have love. And remember, what a lot of people don't understand is 1 Corinthians 13 comes in the context of really a couple confusing passages of 1 Corinthians 12 and then 14 talking about tongues and prophecy and spiritual gifts. And he's like, hey guys, if you think any of that is the bigger deal, if you can speak in the tongues of men and of angels, and if you can understand all wisdom and all knowledge, but you don't have love, then you're a zero. You are nothing. So that's something I hope that we will always remember as a church here at Compass Bible Church Treasure Valley, that God has called us to love one another. And if we don't love one another, it really doesn't matter what else we've got going on. And again, even in this time, we're coming back to church, praise God, right? And we'll be having an announcement later today that'll be exciting. But it doesn't matter if we don't love. And even in this time, I want to encourage you to love others, be considerate to others. I know there's all kinds of opinions out there about how we should be responding to the coronavirus and, you know, all these different things. And I would just encourage you, as you go through that with people in your church, people in your neighborhood, friends, that you say, hey, what's more important than my comfort is my love for the people around me and being considerate of them. And when this current situation is long gone, I know it's still going to be a challenge and a fight for us to love each other as Christ has loved us. I've never been at a church where I'm like, you know what? We're really, I don't think we could possibly be loving one another more. Let's keep going. Let's keep working to love one another. Now, we also continue the story of David today. And yesterday, you remember, I was standing out with the caution tape. Now we start to get to see those effects of sin and the conflict and the division and even the death in David's family that was a result of his sin. And also, we read the interesting question in Mark chapter 12, where the Sadducees ask Jesus, and he says, you don't understand the Bible, not what you want to hear from Christ. But these people, they didn't believe in the resurrection. And Jesus makes clear, no, the Bible makes this clear. You're caught up in questions of, you know, well, hey, whose wife is this lady going to be? When he's like, you're missing the point. It's another thing like we talked about on Sunday, that these religious leaders, they missed the point. And that's what Jesus is rebuking them for today. And another thing that we see him rebuking for other places, they don't really love other people. So that's my encouragement to us as a church today, to remember that, hey, it doesn't matter if we can start meeting again. It doesn't matter if we can start adding kids ministry again. It doesn't matter someday when, hey, we can move the chairs closer and just fill the auditorium like normal again. If we don't have love, we don't have anything. And that's not my opinion. That's what God is telling us today on Revival from the Bible.